Hello everybody and welcome back to our puppet playthrough of Dark Souls, where today we're going to go back to the asylum. John, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Curl up like a ball.
That was exactly what it said too.
People who know this game will know that normally takes a long time, but we went ahead before the recording and A, upgraded our weapons. I don't know that we leveled up at all, but I know we upgraded some Zweihander. At the end of the last episode, and then also picked up the asylum key from the rooftop and got rid of this horrible long wait before the cutscene on the way back to the asylum. So let me know when you're there.
He's dropping me in his nest. Or she?
Excellent.
I don't know.
I don't know, actually.
Hey, I'm back.
Good question. Okay, so now you'll notice that there's some torchmen outside that were not previously here that I think I probably alluded to in the first or second episode.
Yes, you did, and yes, they are.
Okay, they're not chumps. So,
not
prepare
chumps.
Yourself for some flailing. But yeah, dispatch those dudes and let me know when they're dead.
Okay, yeah. I will let you know when they're dead.
They're dead?
No, there's one more. Now they're dead.
Okay, there's a couple more inside the church too, but what I want you to do when you enter the church, hang a right immediately. Don't walk out past the door as far as you can help it. So just barely get inside, then walk to the right and go to that first bonfire, if you remember the one I'm talking about. The one that you run past the demon that's in there to get to in the beginning of the game.
So you're saying go through the first door and then into the second door?
Go through the first door and then hang a right.
Okay, I mean, I'm gonna do that. Should I run, maybe? Or?
It doesn't matter. If there's dudes in there, I don't know if they will aggro at that range.
Okay, I have run in. I see the bonfire. You're
okay,
saying rest at it?
Okay, the bonfire, yeah. How many souls do you have?
2,632.
Okay, we're back. We had a weird audio glitch, but now we're here. John.
Yeah.
You want to try to exit that door that you just came through and pull the dudes in that room to you without going too far into the room.
Okay. I don't remember where all they were.
They're, not the ones that are outside the church, just the ones that are inside the church. There's like two of them roaming around in there.
You mean, like, in where the bonfire is?
No, in the church. Or I guess, I keep calling it a church, but it's really not. It's just, like, a church-looking thing. I guess this whole area is an asylum. I don't know what the fuck you would call it. It's a giant building.
Where I fought the big dude last time.
Yes. The big boss room.
Okay. I don't know. You have me concerned that I shouldn't go out far.
You shouldn't. That's a good concern to have.
But, at the same time, they don't seem interested in me right here.
Okay, well, actually, I guess it really doesn't matter, because I think they die as soon as this thing happens anyway. So I want you to run, or not run, I want you to walk out toward the middle of the room and just plunging attack as soon as it happens.
Just what attack?
The plunging attack, the attack you get when you fall.
Oh, okay. I did it. It did nothing.
It didn't. Okay, well, you're a boss town now.
I guess I was in the other direction. This is good. This is fine.
See how you do against this boss.
Yeah. Probably not well. Oh, God. Dead. I'm dead.
Yeah, he's not the same. So I just wanted to see how that would go. He's not the same as the other one. This dude's for real.
Yeah.
He's got magic.
Magic?
Did he not even use that?
I don't think so, no.
Oh, boy. Okay, that's the real problem in that fight. Is the magic. And getting the dodges right. You can try to fight him again. Just to see how you do, because your weapon should do a significant amount of damage to him. But it's not an easy fight, and like dodging his attacks can be really difficult.
Also, how close where can I make the ground fall from? Can you actually plunging attack that guy? That seems far away from where
he's starting. Pretty sure you can, but I mean, I don't know. It depends on when you fall, where you fall through.
No, he's way back far.
Is he? Okay, I could have been totally making that up in my head. I feel like it started much closer to him. I'm thinking of a different boss from a different game. You fall through the floor a lot in these games. into boss fights.
I would imagine.
Yeah. So he's got a couple of attacks outside of his normal just like swings and his butt stomp. He has, which his butt stomp is really bad because it explodes. So you want to be nowhere near him when he flies into the sky.
Yeah, man, this guy is not fooling around at all. I couldn't get near him, and he hit me like 3 times. I couldn't even get up from my previous downment.
So he has a move where he casts out an explode. Basically, he casts out an explosion that will happen some amount of distance out in front of him. And then he has one that will happen, I'm forgetting. I don't know if it's right in front of him or... He has two different types that he can throw around. But it's mostly just important to learn if it's the close one or the far one and how to deal with each. Since you're not blocking, which is what most people do to get through them, because they deal a shitload of damage, you mostly just want to, like, recognize if it's near you to sprint the other direction or if it's on top of him to sprint away.
Okay.
Because there's really no good way to actually dodge the attack outside of just being outside of its range. And sticking on top of his ass is usually a pretty good option, too. Because very few of them can hit you while you're behind him. Like, he can't cast them behind him. But, okay. if you don't actually feel like fucking with him, he's totally optional. And actually considered a late game boss.
Oh.
Like, much deeper than you are currently.
Right, yeah, he killed me again. Man, that was way hardcore, yeah. Okay, so I won't go with him anymore.
Then. The thing we're here for doesn't concern him. However, he does have one of the only... There's like 3 of them, I think, that are obtainable. There's not a lot. There's very few of the final upgrade material for weapons in a playthrough. It's called a Titanite Slab.
That sounds
and
cool.
And he has one of them.
All right.
So that should give you some idea of where they expect you to be when you
kill
him.
What am I doing then?
Continue through the zone like you did the first time. So from that bonfire, go to the right and then up that tunnel where there was previously a guy, an archer. You remember that? Where you picked up your shield?
Yeah, there's a giant white silhouette guy.
Yeah, that's a Black Knight dude. I don't really have any advice for him other than don't get hit.
Don't get hit. Really great advice.
You can backstab him, and you can flatten him with the archery, with the RT on your weapon, the strong attack.
Oh, jeez. I got hit once, but it didn't seem that bad.
Okay, that's good.
I did die.
Is that the one with this? Okay, is that the one with sword and shield? They have
combos.
Yeah,
sword and shield.
That's the problem.
Yeah. I think I'll be all right against this guy. I just got to not be dead.
Yeah, so, that's a definite requirement for this fight.
Right. Don't be dead. Well, actually, don't be more dead. I don't know.
Don't die while you're undead.
Man, what a game this is.
Also, fighting him in that hallway is kind of difficult. Like, there's no real good spot to fight him unless you kite him up to the balcony area that is behind him.
Yeah.
But if you do that incorrectly, you can get stuck in the doorway, so.
He is really aggressively pushing towards me.
Yeah, he wants you dead real bad. Good news.
I think
is
I killed.
You...
Oh no, didn't kill him.
Oh jeez.
He's dead. All right.
Okay. Now that you've killed him, he doesn't respawn, so.
Black Knight Sword.
Oh, really?
Red Titanite. Something.
They drop their whole weapon set, so like the other ones that have they have halberds and there's a great sword also.
That's cool.
They're not super common drops as far as I'm aware. I don't think the rarity's been affected, but they don't drop off of every guy, so.
Okay.
Cool that you got one. It's an all red sword. It's heavy shit.
So I go into this next place. Stairs.
So yeah, you want to go into where the boulder is and try not to get hit by the boulder.
Oh. I feel like I'm in a different place. Oh no, I'm not. Okay. So the guy's gonna send another boulder? Oh, this guy's angry.
Right, I forgot about him. Yeah, you're gonna have to deal with him.
Oscar?
Is it Oscar? Yeah.
I don't know, is it?
Is it the guy in the Elite Knight? Because
yeah.
I talked about his name before.
I mean, he is dead.
Okay.
Pick up item. Why is he angry this time?
Because he went hollow. Shield.
Oh. Crest shield.
Crest shield, yeah. That's a good... It's an alright shield, actually. It's not bad. But since we're avoiding shields for the time being, we just kind of...
That ball tracked a little bit. I didn't know that was an option.
Well, it curves as it gets down the thing.
Okay. I don't need to go in that room where his body was.
I don't think there's anything in there. You can go look, but I don't... I think it's empty. Second time around.
And I'm going up.
Yeah,
upstairs. Where the boulder were.
Yep,
Wurs.
Wurs, yep.
Okay. Through the door.
Yep.
I'm assuming I'm going to that door behind the shield guy.
Yeah, that's there should be a gate back there that you can open now.
Yeah, probably. I haven't gone over
there. Or door or something. I don't remember the exact layout of it. This is probably the thing. One of the things I remember the least. Very rarely do I actually go and get this item that we're going to get.
Okay.
But I feel like it might help you since it's your first time through this area.
Sure. Oh, there's two shieldmen now.
Yeah.
Why would they do this to me?
I mean, your weapon is so big, though.
I meant, why would they, like, play a joke? Because these guys are nerds and definitely not going to kill me.
Why would they annoy you with this?
Yes, why would they give me this? Well, this guy's
because if they
a real
do,
hard time.
Yeah, I was going to say, because if they do kill you, you're going to feel like total shit. Like, that's why.
But it's fine, they're dead.
Okay. So go ahead. there is a door behind them, right?
I got a Titanite shard from one of their corpses.
Radical.
Yeah, there is the door. The
okay,
door
go ahead and open it. And it should lead to the top side of the broken staircase. It's on the opposite side of the actual staircase.
Okay, yeah.
And there should be a body with an idol on the staircase part of it.
Yes.
Okay.
Rusted iron ring.
Perfect. Okay. So you're not wearing two rings currently, right?
I don't believe so, no.
You're only wearing Havel's?
Yes.
Okay. You might as well throw that on. That way we don't forget it later. It's not going to do anything for you for a while because it does is allow you to move through water as if there was no water.
Hmm.
So you're not going to be infringed by the slowdown effects of any liquid or rough terrain, as they describe it in the description of the ring.
Improves balance of poor footing.
Yeah, that's a really bad description.
Yeah.
What that ring actually does, yeah.
That's, like, what you were saying versus what it has written is very different.
Yeah.
That's confusing. Okay, where do I go from here?
You go back to Firelink.
We're done here. All right, cool.
Wait. There's another item here.
Right on.
Where's
where
it
do
at?
I go?
I gotta remember where it's at. Oh no.
Remember.
There's totally another item we need. Yeah. I don't think you need to beat the big boss man to get it.
I mean, there's nothing else here. Like, I feel like we've explored all of this area. Hey, look, the ball.
That's what I thought too. Is there an area I'm forgetting about?
Seems like some unused game space.
Oh, okay. Right. You have to go through that, so the room that the boss, that the full floor falls through that leads to the boss?
Yeah.
You have to skirt that, like, floor breaking area. You can get to the door. Right, or even you could take the stairs down from, from where the boulder is.
Yeah, I did that.
You want to go back to the first cell where you started the game.
Neat. Nostalgia already. There's a giant... Oh, right. I forgot. I genuinely forgot to be in this game already. I forgot there is this big ladder.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look, guys.
Also,
I'm not going to slip and fall and die
on this water.
I think there's
another Black Knight in that hallway.
That's not okay. Why would you say
on the way
this
back
thing?
To the cell.
Because of all the escaping prisoners?
I was definitely pretty sure there was two.
Yep. Yeah, they're easier. Dude is very here.
Here, deal with him. I mean, you probably should hit that bonfire right outside of the area where you are, but not a very
long
walk.
Should have said
back.
That before I got impaled.
It's like the difference of 10 seconds, so. Are you dead already?
No, I'm not. I might be. Oh, God.
What does he have? Halberd, sword?
Sword. He's dead.
Okay,
yeah, he'd also dropped a sword.
Fun fact, if you look to the left side of that hallway where the like the gates are broken in, you can see the boss below that area, just stomping about in there.
Huh. It's a shame I can't throw something at him.
Yeah, you can actually see him at the beginning of the game.
Really?
Yeah.
Did I just walk right past it?
You did.
That's crazy. That just shows how, like, oblivious... I want to say gamers are? I don't know. I mean,
there's like... really no reason, like, no one would be like, oh, I should look at the sides of this hallway for some reason.
A peculiar doll.
Okay, good. That's the other thing we needed. We don't need it now, and we won't need it for a while. But, and actually, I don't ever know... Maybe that'll be something we'll do after we beat the game.
Okay.
Because, that item allows you to go to one of the very few optional areas in Dark Souls.
So we're going to avoid areas and go to optional areas.
No, we're just picking that up in case we go back. Oh. Because that area is really cool. And now we don't have to ever come back here unless we want to kill that demon.
I kind of want to kill it now, but...
You can try it. I mean, I think your weapon does enough damage, and you should have enough armor and health to survive that fight. In theory, if you get the pattern down... there's no reason why you can't kill it. But it's not immediately necessary.
Like
either.
A priority. I was hoping I could like get the floor to fall and then roll out of it.
I don't think there's any way
to
do that.
To be an option.
I think it's something I've tried a ton again.
I'm really gonna try it. I'm just gonna jump. Man, I want it bad. Nope, not gonna happen. He's angry. I'm dead. Gosh. Yeah. We'll just wait on this guy.
That's a rough fight. Yeah, I mean, it's still, even at the end of the game, when you're meant to be attacking him, it's still not an easy fight.
Okay.
The only, like, upside of that fight is that he doesn't have a ton of health.
I went for it again just one more time. Not the actual fight, not the jump.
Oh, okay. Does that put you in the fight?
No, I did. I don't know. I didn't, like, I didn't go in it far enough.
Oh, okay, alright. Well, head back up to the, actually, did we ever pick up that rubbish?
Yes.
We did?
Yeah, totally.
We might as well do that while we're here.
What are we doing with rubbish?
We'll go back up to, go back out to where you came in at and kill those four torch guys. Clear them all away. Let me know when they're dead.
I will do that. Boy, just come in the door, guy. Not a big problem. Wow. They are frustrating, these guys.
Yeah, they're total bastards.
They're all dead.
Okay, so head to the crow's nest that's on the right-hand side, the one that's, like, barely on that one ledge. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
Okay, so go stand in it.
In it?
Let me know when you're standing in it, like, on top of it.
You, give me warm. Yeah, I'm standing in it.
Okay, so the birds, that's the warm and soft crow. Crows?
Okay.
There are multiple crows. You never see them, and I don't know that it's ever confirmed that it's the same crow that carries you, but there's a version of these in every game. This one, they want warm and soft stuff. Dark Souls 2, they want smooth and silky stuff. One of the games, they want, like, shiny and sparkly or something. I don't know.
They
want
something different every game.
Yeah, sure. Yes, exactly. This one, they want warm and soft. So, rubbish is the exact definition of warm and soft in Dark Souls. So, go ahead.
Yeah.
Go into your inventory. And then select it, and there should be an option to leave.
Drop?
Is it drop now? Okay, I can't remember. there's simultaneously option for drop and discard. Which is weird.
I have dropped it.
Okay, so it should have appeared like a little gold bag on the ground?
Yeah, a little gold bag, yeah.
Quit the game.
Quit the game?
Yes.
Okay.
And then reload it.
This is weird. Alright, load game, sure.
Let me know when you're back in.
Okay. I'm back in.
Alright, pick up the item.
You give me warm
I think I have to go through their little dialogue first.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Pick up item. Oh, wow. All right.
What'd you get?
Tide Knight Chunk.
Yep. Tide Knight Chunk. Cool. So we'll need that. Actually, oh, okay. Not immediately, but in a little bit. We'll need that eventually. So we have that now. There are other items you can drop and get stuff from them. Moss is a thing, but I don't remember what every item in the game translates to. I mostly just remember that that's the only use for the rubbish in the entire game. So you might as well get that chunk and at least you have that. Maybe we'll come back here after I find a guide for like this translates to this, and we'll get rid of all the items you don't need, but that's so time consuming. We'll do that off camera. Because every time you do that, you can only do one item at a time, and you have to leave game and rejoin every time.
Weird. That's weird.
Yeah, it's an interesting but weird mechanic. Like, just imagine how long it took people to figure that shit out.
Yeah. Some time, I imagine.
Yeah, it wasn't quick. Like, I remember reading wikis. You can head back up, and we're going back to Firelink now.
Okay.
But I remember reading, like, guides and, like, the Dark Souls wiki weeks after the game was dropped. After people had already beaten it, still parts of it getting fleshed out, people understanding, like, humanity took forever for people to understand the full effects of, figuring out that it scaled with a single weapon in the game was not known for a while. there was a bunch of shit. That Smooth and Silky, or the, I keep calling it Smooth and Silky, but the Soft and Warm Crow, building that table out, I'm sure it took a fucking monumental effort. Of dropping every single item in the game just to see.
I don't know. I'm still a little bit mind blown of the having to like leave the game, like to quit the game and come back. That's crazy.
Yeah. Well, Dark Souls automatically auto saves every time you quit it. So.
Okay.
Like there's a, like it's doing that anyway. So it's probably grabbing that. It's like, oh, this is the world state. When you close the game out, oh, there's an item here.
Am I going back to the fire?
Yeah, go ahead and rest at the fire. Trying to think if there's anything else we want to do before we head down.
Oh, man, I never know.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't know.
Rest at the bonfire, and then, you already know the way, because, off camera, we open some doors here, just so John knew where he was going, because describing this part is kind of weird. But we're going to Blighttown. We're going the back way. So, you want to head down to the stairs below the bonfire at Firelink, and then take the other stairs down, and then take the elevator down. We're going deep, deep down.
Yes. I remember this path.
How deep do you think this goes, out of curiosity?
You mean, like, the whole game?
Like, yeah. Like, if...
I mean, like, I think it could solve some personal issues for some people. That's how deep I think it gets. I don't know, though.
Like, Blighttown, so the area you go to, like, the new Londo Ruins, that ghost town area with all the water.
Yeah.
That's below Firelink, right? Because you got to take those stairs down to get to it.
Yeah, and a crazy giant elevator.
Right, and the crazy giant elevator. So you go, let me know, are you down all that yet? Are you there yet? I don't know where you're at currently.
Yes.
I'm just kind of talking like, you already know the way. Like I said, I walked him through this off camera just to get the map in your mind. So, while you're walking. So the new Londo Ruins are below that. And then you walk out through the, you go up those little steps in that tower, right? You go across that plank and into the cave, right?
Yeah.
That's where we're headed, to that cave tunnel. That cave tunnel leads to an area that you take, like, four ladders, four very long ladders, and then an elevator that's run by, like, a weird water wheel system that I still don't understand, all the way down to the bottom of that zone. At the bottom of that zone, you go to a cave that leads down to a boss fight that is down another set of stairs.
Yeah.
That zone is the beginning of a whole nother zone that goes even further down.
Oh, right, I'm sorry. I'm not supposed to go down that weird little wooden path, right?
The plank bridge? Yeah, go ahead. We're going to the cave.
Oh, there was a body. I picked up a sword.
Good, yeah. I think there's two bodies. There might be one behind the gate, too.
Yeah, I already got that guy.
Okay.
There's a man in a jar here. Should I break him out?
Yeah.
Did it anyway. There was nothing.
Okay.
Okay. So
are you sure there was nothing?
Across these... No. The body took a little bit, sorry.
Yeah, they all the ones that you break out of Doris take a really long time. Oh, good.
Transient curses.
Wait, where are you at?
See, this is why
you went the wrong way. Okay. You have to go up. You have to turn to the right and go up the stairs. I thought you were talking about the other plank bridge to the cave.
Nope. Okay.
So apparently you didn't remember.
Oh, right. Go off to the right. I know. Yeah. I totally didn't remember right this tower. Now I remember.
Okay.
And then I go up these stairs, yeah?
Mm-hmm. And the gate should already be open because we've been there once before. At least you got those curses. We'll need those later.
Yeah. Hey, there's this body, too. Another large, nameless soul guy.
Okay, good. Yeah, that's the body plank, I thought you were looting. Yeah. So when you get across the plank, actually, you should be at the cave, just about at the mouth of the cave.
Yeah.
If you continue past that...
Sure.
Across the ledge, what do you see down there?
It looks like a building, like more structure.
Like, deeper. Do you see a big grass area along the cliffside with a bunch of bodies?
Ew. Should I be looking deeper down?
I don't know which way you're looking.
I don't know either. I see, like, buttresses.
Buttresses?
Yes.
At left of the cave mouth?
No. I went right. Okay, I thought you said continue past the cave.
I did say continue past.
What, you want me to go to the left?
Isn't that... Yes, that would be the only way that continues past. So the right has... there isn't anywhere to go.
I mean, there was a little bit of a ledge. Okay, there's like a bridge.
Bridge.
Yeah, like if I continue on the ledge... There's a wooden bridge.
A wooden bridge? Okay. Go ahead and cross that.
That has some giant... thing that I really don't know how to describe.
It's a giant undead dragon.
Yeah?
So right now it's asleep.
And you want me to walk over there?
Well, I want you to walk near it. So, the way that this fight goes, the way that you can do this fight right now. And it's super easy.
Yeah?
All you have to do, when that dragon wakes up, because he doesn't have a huge range of attacks, and he doesn't move from that spot. So... you get a free hit. He won't wake up until you attack him or until you loot one of the bodies. Like, you can get pretty much right up next to him, and I think he'll still be asleep unless they change that or unless I'm misremembering.
Go across this bridge.
Yeah, go ahead and walk across the bridge. I mean, if you see him moving, then back up. But okay. I think you're fine up until you get, like, right in front of him.
So what am I doing then?
Okay, so you want to get yourself close enough that you can hit his right... paw hand thing, whatever dragons have.
Yeah.
Claw.
Ball? Paw?
Claw, oof. Paw. You want to hit it one time with your strongest attack, like your strong attack, and then you want to run away. Because what the dragon will do is he'll wake up and he'll spew poison all over the ground. Like, really bad poison. I think it's even toxic. So, you can stand directly out, like, you can hit him and then run outside the range of the poison. Run back in, hit him again, and just do that over and over again. He doesn't take very many hits.
Okay, but he's never going to leave?
He'll never leave, no.
Will he spew that acid on a time thing or only when I'm there?
I think it's only when you're close enough to trigger it. He does have, like, some swipes, which is why you have to not be near his hand when he's not spewing.
Boy, he does that pretty quick. I might have to run in. I don't know. Oh, man. You can get pretty close to him. Okay.
He's really not as scary as he looks.
Yeah, no, he's way scary looking.
There's another one later in the game that is significantly harder to deal with, but... you may never end up seeing it, so...
Not taking a lot of damage, I gotta tell you.
Oh, really? What are you at? +7 on that sword? +8?
+8, even.
Wow. These are more health than I remember. I guess that fight, I always relegate that to that dude being a bitch because you can do that fight without ever getting hit. And there's really nothing you can do about it.
Oh, I just fell off the map.
Well, that is the one way that you'll die on that fight.
Can't cure that.
What happened that happened?
I didn't want to lock on because you were saying hit him in the paw. And the lock one's, like, somewhere in his neck, so I was just swinging freely.
You literally swung yourself off the cliff.
Yeah, I swung myself off the cliff, yeah.
That's much worse.
Yeah.
Oof, that's rough. Okay, well, that's an episode.
Woo, I did. I killed myself like an idiot.
Well, we'll start the net. We'll pick the next one up. Maybe we'll try that again on the beginning of the episode. Yeah. Maybe we'll just go into the cave. We'll leave it
Seems
up.
Seems reasonable.
But for now, bye.
Bye.